import logos in fall, import, and just this, click OK. And I'm going to use the bezier tool to follow the shape of the Batman logos without the text. So press B on your keyboard to activate the bezier tool, or you can click this icon, the pen tool. Okay, I start from the middle of the logos, click, and you can make a curve. So on this point, just drag, and on this point, click a round shape in here. So just drag, okay, click in here, and to here. Can drag. Now I'm going to lock the corner, hold shift. Okay, see the knot handle, it's only this knot. Then release your mouse and release the shift and connect it to here. So let's drag and hold shift to lock the corner again and release your mouse. Okay, and release the shift and click. So you see it's point in here, click, click, and little curves here. Okay, now how you can end the path. So a pencil trick, press shift L on the keyboard to remove this handle. So if I press shift L, you see the knot will point to the last point and connect it to the first knot. I make it only half because for this part we use the mirror symmetry path effect. Okay, let me move this first, and I want to change the common properties with no page border, so it's like you're free on the canvas. In fall, document properties, and uncheck this border. And for the desk, you can change it to fully white. Turn on this enable snapping, it's really helpful if you want to create some mirror. Select this part and change the color to this black color and remove the stroke. Right click, choose remove stroke. Add some mirror symmetry path effect. So click the object and go to path, choose path effect and find the mirror symmetry. And you can adjust it with knot tool. Shortcut is N or F2. After you're happy with the result, apply the path effect by going to path, choose object to path. Now the mirror symmetry is gone, that means the path effect is applied on this object. And the last, I'm going to add the text element like this reference, the classic Batman logos. So press T on your keyboard and click and type, and you can change the font to, I think this font is close to this reference. Okay, and I want to change the color to same as this yellow, so press T to activate the eyedropper tool and click this color. Convert the text to path by going to path and choose object to path. Split it one by one so it's turned into all letters. Go to path, choose split path. So with selector tool, if you see the B, A, T, it's one by one. Okay, start from the B, so click. And with the path effect in path, choose the path effects and find the lattice deformation. With the selector tool, you can move it to here, and with the knot tool, or the shortcut is N or F2, you can try to drag this node. So start from here and this. And the middle, if you want to create a curve so it follows the logos. Okay, like that. And if you want to create a curve for this, so I believe this handle. And for the A, do the same. Active the lattice deformation. Move it to here and press F2. And start to drag the handles. You can remove the enable snapping for now. If you want to do more variation, so let's try. I'm duplicating this, press Ctrl D to duplicate. And I want to change the color to this color, press D, then click. And you can see some of these strokes, so right click, choose black stroke. If your path after use the mirror symmetry, same like me, you can use the second method, okay? Remove the stroke, right click, choose remove stroke. And duplicate this shape, press Ctrl D to duplicate. And go to path, choose the outset. And let's change the fill color to this black color. And send it to the bottom. And you can increase the stroke by going to path, choose outset. Or if you want to select the back object, so press Alt then click. Until you see the fill color change to this black color. That means the black color is in selected. And let's unite the letters, so shift click and these two, and get the path, choose the union. After you unite them, press Ctrl D to duplicate, and get the path, choose the outset, and change the color to this black color and move it to the lower. I hope you learned something new, how we can create this classic Batman logos. So the important thing in this logo, it's good for practice if you want to make the text fit to the shape in Inkscape. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.